this point, budget cuts are also going to be necessary, and I intend to make them. Here you have my word. I'll proceed carefully. I understand this is a delicate task. Our government rightfully provides a safety net for the hungry and the homeless, the sick and the elderly, and we have a responsibility to keep it intact for future generations.
When I hear the story of a single mom struggling to put food on the table, or a child born into poverty, or a dad who's gone months without a paycheck, I cannot sit idly by.
One of the things that helped make this country great was the sense that if you worked hard and if you used your talents well, that you'd be on a path towards opportunity. Every single parent wants to tell their child that if they work hard, they're going to be successful.
When you've worked hard and done well and walked through that doorway of opportunity, you do not slam it shut behind you. No, you reach back and you give other folks the same chances that help you succeed.
Today, more Americans wake up in poverty than ever before. Nearly one out of six Americans is living in poverty. Look around you. These aren't strangers. These are our brothers and sisters, our fellow Americans.
It turns out that advancing equal opportunity and economic empowerment is both morally right and good economics.
And it has been a constant struggle, long and hard, up and down, to try to extend the benefits of the American dream to all.
In America, we believe in freedom and the responsibility that comes with it to work hard to make the dream of reaching our God-given potential come true.
America didn't become the land of opportunity by accident. My grandmother's generation and generations before always saw beyond the horizons of their own lives and their own circumstances. They believed that opportunity created today would lead to prosperity tomorrow.
Work hard and get married before you have children, and the chance you will ever be in poverty is just 2%.
Opportunity is slipping away from us. We're seeing more and more children end up where they started. In other words, if they started low in the economic ladder, they end up low in the economic ladder. That's something we absolutely have to do something about to give that sense that in this country, if you work hard, you can in fact be successful.
The dream is universal, but America makes it possible, and our investment in opportunity makes it a reality.